So if you have more stem cells in your body, you will just be able to have a greater health. That's what Steminins does. All it does, it doesn't heal anything, it doesn't cure anything. All it does is that it promotes rebuilding so that you improve and you experience wellness. A question that often comes is it safe for the bone marrow to constantly release stem cells like this from the bone marrow? There's a powerful mechanism in the bone marrow to maintain homeostasis, a specific number and constant number of stem cells. You don't run out of stem cells. Steminins does not trigger a release of stem cells that is beyond what your body already naturally does on its own. We need to understand that in the body, what happens, the way that cells divide and maintain themselves in the bone marrow is a different process than elsewhere in nature. Everywhere in nature, what we have is cells divide through a process called symmetrical cellular division. I have one cell that divides into two identical daughter cells. What happens is that the DNA makes a copy, and then one piece of the original DNA goes in each cell, a piece of the copy goes in each cell, so you end up with two identical cells that have one piece of original, one copy. In the bone marrow, it's different. In the bone marrow, you have what is called asymmetrical cellular division. The DNA duplicates, but the original goes into one cell, that one stays in the bone marrow. The other one, the copies goes into the other cell, that one goes in the blood. That cell is destined to travel and become a tissue cell. This process is meant to basically keep in the bone marrow your original DNA that you had from the day you're born, you have it until the day you die. And the reason why I'm talking about this is that anytime a cell goes into the blood, a sister cell was left in the bone marrow. So what we talked about before with stem enhance, 25% increase is roughly 3 million stem cells being released in the bloodstream. That's a fair amount of stem cells. Well, it does not mean that now you're lacking 3 million stem cells in the bone marrow. They've multiplied. So you basically keep the same number of stem cells in the bone marrow. The bone marrow is this powerful way of maintaining balance and homeostasis. Now, over the past 2 years, we have done a number of studies to extend the information that we had on steminins. The first one, very interesting, is do the released stem cells reach the target tissue? Why is this question pertinent? It's pertinent because what I have on one hand is the information pertaining to many, many hundreds of studies that are not about steminins. They're about stem cells in the body, GCSF, and all of these other products. But I know from these studies that more stem cells in the blood equates to greater health. I have a product that I can show increases the number of stem cells in the blood. So I put the two together, it is a legitimate claim to say the product by increasing stem cells in the blood will help overall health. But there's a point where I need to show that steminins itself does not only increase the number of stem cells, but these stem cells released from the bone marrow do indeed go to tissue, and the whole story is true. So that's what we did soon after, is the first study that we did to basically prove the concept and link all of it together. So very simple study. We irradiated mice, kills all the stem cells. Again, this is a kind of study that you cannot do in any other way than to do it in animals. So we irradiated mice, injected fluorescent stem cells. So we have a normal mouse whose stem cells are green fluorescent. So if they move and go into any tissue, we will have cells of that tissue that will be green. Then, so it repopulates the bone marrow. Then we do an injury to the muscle by injecting cardiotoxin. It kills the muscle. And then we basically split the animals in two groups, one group control, one group on stem enhance. Quite simple. And then we're looking at the recovery, and we can do that by taking whole body picture of the animals without having to touch the animals. So you can follow the recovery. And 6 weeks later, what we got is a number of things very, very interesting. First, if we look at the control animal, you can see that the muscle has regenerated quite significantly. You can see the muscle has come back. But when you add steminins in the diet, the recovery is much greater. So we're proving the concept here. Putting more stem cells in the bloodstream will lead to a greater repair. But it does demonstrate the other part of our story, which is just as important. It is a natural process. Without doing anything, it happened nonetheless. Steminins just make it faster and more powerful. And it also demonstrated the third part of our concept, which is when we looked at the other leg, the left leg, that did not have an injury, we see very, very little migration in the muscle. It happens naturally. It happens more when you have more stem cells, and it goes where you have the injury, not where you don't have the injury. So it's a very directed process. So that study really showed those three pillars, if you want, of our whole concept. So One way to capture everything is by a tool called a quality of life questionnaire. The questionnaire is a very simple tool aimed at assessing your quality of life. And the study published 15 years ago concluded that by simply asking you, how do you feel, it is much more powerful to determine what's your problem and to help you recover optimal health. So it's essentially to determine what is your overall quality of life. If your liver functions better, you have better quality of life. Your pancreas works better, you have better quality of life. Your brain is better, better quality of life. Your joints are better, you have better quality of life. So all of this can be captured by quality of life. So that's what we did. We did that questionnaire. You can see a sample of that question at the website, Am I Healthy? You can do the questionnaire. There's a sample there. It will tell you how you compare with the overall national average of health for your age and everything. And then you can basically see, as you talk to text eminence, how it changes your overall quality of life. But that's what we've done. And this is a typical report that we get. That's a difference in 1 month. So we basically took the results on day one, and then 30 days after being on Steminence, and we have the percentage difference on 10 different parameters: general health, physical functioning, your ability to bodily pain, vitality, social functioning. For example, the questionnaire will ask you, instead of saying, are you depressed? They will ask you, how many friends have you seen this week? If you're depressed, it's zero. If you're full of joy, it's 10, 15, 20. So by a lot of these indirect questions, they can determine your quality of life in a very, very scientific way and very, very valid way. So on average, everybody, on every single parameters, we have an improvement within only 1 month. So essentially, what this study is telling us is that when you confound everything, you take everything under one big umbrella, everybody experiences some level of improvement in quality of life after 1 month. So it was a very good study here to capture what the product does as a whole. Hair study. When we launched the product, a lot of people started to report within the months after, following, that they were slowly returning to their natural hair color. At first, I thought that the report, the testimonials were sort of silly. I actually didn't like the story. I was telling people, don't exaggerate anything. Don't say things that are unreal. Just stick to the truth, and it's strong enough with what we have at this point. We don't have to go into any kind of exaggeration. And then one day a friend of mine came in and says, well, it's really happening to me. And then it started to happen to me. So we contracted with a lab in cosmetology. And first, what I did is that I went in Medline, which is the library of the National Institute of Health. And I plugged in adult stem cells and melanocytes, the cells responsible for hair pigmentation. Fair enough. Documentation exists, stem cells can become melanocytes. So, you know what? There was a basis to this. So we went to a lab of cosmetology, and on 6 individuals, we followed using very sophisticated tools of taking pictures of the hair and analyzing the color, essentially, the density of white in the hair, and following this over a number of months by taking Steminence. Like this fellow that you see to the left, his head was entirely like pure white. And as you can see right now, it is not totally, totally pure white. But what was interesting is that when you look in from the back, there's a row of black hair, and in the center of his head where he had a crown, he's starting out to have black hair growing. So it's cases like this that prompted us really to look at this seriously, because it was really there. So what we discovered is that after 6 months, when we take picture of the back of the head, there was a 15% reduction in the white density in the hair. So there was a 15% darkening of the hair. And here are a few pictures. This one is not so obvious, but this one, for example, is fairly obvious. And then we took pictures on the side of the head, and this one we had a 20% reduction in the white in the hair. And you can see it here in these different pictures. So talking about hair color is not in itself relevant to health. Hair color is not in itself anything that means anything important, when we talk about health. But it does have an amazing symbol. What else do we have in the body as a symbol of rejuvenation? What do you know that you can take orally that is going to reverse to your natural hair color? Nothing is known to do that. So to take something that is so powerful in the body in terms of rejuvenation to give you back your original hair color is a powerful message, and hair color is not a disease. Graying hair is not a disease. So we can use that message without any problem with the FDA, without talking in any way about disease. And that's the reason why we did that study. We will come up with that report. Steminence is the only product.